And Rajasthan Chief Minister Vasundhara Raje and Union of Finance Minister Arun Jaitley released the BJP Manifesto for Rajasthan, making promises on education of girls and empowerment of farmers, as the party hopes to beat a perceived anti-incumbency wave to keep the Congress at bay. Several top leaders of the BJP were also present there on the occasion. And speaking at the release of the election document, the Chief Minister promised every year 30,000 jobs will be given in government sector in the state. Now, elections, remember, are on the 7th of December.
शिक्षित युवाओं को रोजगारोन्मुख करने के लिए उनको रोजगार मिले ऐसे संयोजित करने की सामाजिक जिम्मेदारी लेते हुए 21 वर्ष से अधिक के शिक्षित बेरोजगारों को निर्धारित मापदंडों के अंतर्गत अधिकतम 5,000 रुपए प्रति माह देकर बेरोजगारी भत्ता देने का काम करेंगे सरकारी क्षेत्र में प्रतिवर्ष लगभग 30,000 सरकारी नौकरी देने के साथ साथ आगामी 5 वर्ष में स्वरोजगार और निजी क्षेत्र में 50 लाख रोजगार के अवसर सृजित करने का काम किया जाएगा ग्रामीण क्षेत्र में रोजगार गारंटी नरेगा की तर्ज पर शहरी रोजगार गारंटी कानून इसको हम बनाने का काम करेंगे
All right, let's go across to Harsha for more on the manifesto release. And Harsha, tell us what other highlights are there of the manifesto.
Well, the main focus, very clearly, is youth and farmers. So if you see, and that really is are the two big, big issues in this election in Rajasthan. Employment has been a huge issue. So very clearly, before that also, she announced that I had promised 3 lakh government jobs. And have delivered on 2 lakh and another 1 lakh are in the pipeline. And now she's announced about 30,000 government jobs. That works out to about 1.5 lakh over 5 years if the BJP is voted back to power. But interestingly, 50 lakh job opportunities. That's what's been announced. So that's interesting. It's not government jobs. It's job opportunities. Also, if you look at it, educated people under certain terms and conditions who are above 21 years of age will be given an unemployment dole. Now, remember, there were a lot of issues about jobs, especially for youth. And wherever you go, unemployment is a big, big, big issue. Secondly, also for farmers. So if you notice, very interestingly, no SOPs, in the sense no farm loan waivers have been announced, but there's been announced the setting up of a loan commission. Now, that's very interesting. So the loan commission will be in every division. There will be a bench. And the loan commission will, on a case-to-case basis, look at farmers' loan waivers as and when required. So that's the long-term plan. Also, according to the Swaminathan Commission's recommendation, which was also said in the last manifesto, the fact that they want to double farmers' incomes, for that, the way forward is to do it through MSP. Now, here again, they've not, of course, it's not in the purview of a state government, but they're not announcing, sudden increase in MSPs, but they're saying that the delivery will become better. So that's very, very important, that the delivery of MSPs will become better. And what they're also announcing is, the need to have more irrigated. That's another way of increasing farmers' income. So really, the focus is on farmers and youth. Of course, a little bit of the BJP's promises to yoga, etc., have come in. So I found it very interesting to hear that there'll be a yoga bhavan in every district. So everybody in district headquarters can now start doing yoga in the yoga bhavan.